subject of the formula, and today we want to continue from the particular area where we stopped. And we have an example here. Remember, I told you that there are some procedures you will need to follow to be able to achieve your subject of formula, to ensure that your subject stands alone. And for you to achieve that, what do you do? Number one, you check out if there are fractions in your question, try to, you know, clear it. Or when you have a square root, or you have square, or whatever you have, you try to clear it, then ensuring that your subject is on one side. After your rearrangement, you ensure that it's on one side, then after which you can now resolve the question. This morning we have a question here, and we are asked to make x the subject of the formula, where we have 1 over y equals 1 over w plus 1 over x. This has nothing to do with square, this has nothing to do with square root. If you look at it, everything is purely fractions. So for us to achieve this, and what we have here now is plus. For us to achieve this, we can simply go by the LCM, LCM of y, w, and x. If you look at y, w, x, they have nothing in common. So when we are talking of LCM, y, w, and x make up the LCM. So the LCM of y, w, and x is the same thing that we have here. You can call it as YWX or X, YW or WXY, as the case may be. So that is why we said the LCM of Y, W, and X is WXY. Then, if you have solved for your LCM, what do? Use that same LCM to multiply each of these fractions. Because you have gotten your LCM now as WXY, you will now use your LCM to divide each of these fractions. Why are you doing that? To be able to clear the fraction. So if we come to this area, 1 over y, which is this, times the LCM, WXY, equals 1 over W times WXY, my LCM, the same thing applicable to 1 over X times WXY. Then, what do you now do? You check out for the common factors by way of canceling the common factors. Y, we cancel this Y. What do we have? WX left. Are you with me? Okay. Then we also go again to cancel the common factors, because this can only be done in multiplication. When we have fractions we want to multiply, we can cancel out common factor. We can only do that when it is carrying a multiplication sign. So W, we cancel W here. What is left? X, Y. That is why we have this. Then X, we go with X here. What do we have left? W, Y. That is what we have here. Then if you look at this, your equation, it's no longer a fraction. You look at it very well. We are trying to make X the subject of the formula. Then we, on the left hand side, we have X. On the right hand side, we have X. So we cannot settle on one. We said you must ensure that they are on the one side. So on this note, we try to bring everything to one side by way of rearranging. Then we come to this area, WX. When we bring in this XY this way, it becomes what? Negative. So we now have WX minus XY equals, because this one is off, what is remaining? WY. So it's standing there. Then what do we do now? Since we have X on two sides, we will simply factorize. If we want to factorize, we will bring out our subject to ensure that our subject is not affected by anything. It will just stand alone. What is common to these sides? WX, XY, it is X that is common. So if you bring the X that is common out, what is now left here? W. That's why we have this. If we bring this X that is common, what is left? Y. So X times W, this will give us the same expression here. So to move forward now, we are trying to ensure that X stands alone. So what do we now do in this regard? We will divide both sides. If you look at it now, we want X to stand alone. And W minus Y is disturbing X. So we try as much as possible to remove it. Where we have addition, the way we can remove it is by subtraction. If we have multiplication, the way we can remove it is by division. And this is X times this bracket. So to remove this W minus Y, we divide both sides by W minus Y. Hence, you have it here. Divide both sides by what? W minus Y. So this is our initial expression, which is this, divided by W minus Y. Then this W Y divided by W minus Y. This we cancel this. What do we have left? X. And that is our X. Then is equals, you know, this is subtraction. We don't know the value of W. You cannot just say this will go with this. When you do that, that is blunder. WY over W minus this one. Supposing we are able to summarize this as a figure and summarize it, we can reduce it. But we cannot go further than this. So, what are we interested? Our interest is based on X. And now X is standing alone. What have we succeeded doing? We have succeeded making X our subject. I hope that one is clear. So let's take in another question and move ahead.
Thank you for the explanation, sir. But my only challenge now is, how do we get the LCM of WSY?
Okay. Now let's go to explaining the LCM. We are going to make use of two methods here. For this contest, we have Y, we have W, and we have X. We are trying to derive the LCM. We can use the division method here, Y, W, X. Then, if you look at this line, what do we use now? What can divide anything here? We can use Y now. Y can divide Y to give us 1. Y cannot go into W, we bring it down. Are you following? Y cannot go into X, we bring it down. So, we come back again. W, we can divide this line by the W. W into W is 1. What is left in our X? Because W cannot go into X exactly. So we bring X down. Then X can go into X to give me 1. Therefore, my LCM is equals Y times W times X. If you multiply this, you have this LCM that we recorded here before initially. Our LCM as what? WXY. I am trying to arrange it alphabetically, otherwise you can go with Y, W, X. Another person may decide to go with X, W, Y. We are still on the same, we are still discussing the same thing. So, that is the LCM. Paraventure, I don't know how to go about this. I can go through the prime factorization method where I have my Y, I have my W, I have my X. In LCM, this one simply means 1 times Y, 1 times W, 1 times X. Are you with me now? So therefore, my LCM will be equals, you know, when we use 1 to multiply a particular number or letter, it remains the same, it does not change. So Y is here, we don't have Y here, we don't have Y here. In LCM, this Y now will stand alone, Y times. Remember, even if we use 1 here, it does not have any effect. We have W here, no W here, no W here. W will represent itself, W times. We have x, no x here, no x here. So this one represents itself, that is x. We'll end up having the same thing, w, x, y. I'm trying to arrange it alphabetically, w, x, y. That is going to be our result. That's how we achieve this. I hope that is clear. So you can now bring out your question, try to do it on your own completely and see how far you're able to do it. Okay.